Hello, Visuals fam, and all you newcomers out there. My name is Ricky, and welcome to the RE Visuals YouTube channel. Now, ever since I started making videos regarding the Dell Optiplex line and taking those PCs and transforming them into gaming PCs, there has been something I've been asked over and over again, and that is, what about the small form factor Dell Optiplexes? All right, I have to admit, I avoided these small form factor systems for a couple of reasons. Mainly, the limited selection of GPUs they will take and the amount of power you can use due to the limited PSU that they come with that really can't be changed out with something else unless you pull all the components out and use them in another case. But today, I have finally given in to all the requests and we're going to take a Dell Optiplex 9020, throw 3 GPUs at it and see what performance you find people can expect from a system like this. So let's take a look at the system that I purchased.
I purchased this Dell Optiplex 9020 on eBay for $185, and I actually think it was a pretty dang good value considering what components I got with it. So the base components that came in this system were an i5-4690 from Intel at 3.5 GHz, clocking up to 3.9 GHz when it turbos, and then as far as RAM, we got 8GB of DDR3, clocked at 1600 MHz, and then this system also came with a 256GB SSD, so load time should be nice and fast, and then these systems come stock with a 255W 80+ bronze rated power supply, so honestly, the GPUs that we're going to be using today should all work just fine and have plenty of power. And then another welcome surprise with this system is that it did come with a Windows 10 Pro license already installed, so didn't have to go out and get a key, but if you guys are doing one of these systems and don't have a CD key for Windows 10 Pro, you should check out UrCDKey.
UrCDKey has discounted codes for games and software that are a fraction of what you would pay if you purchased them from a retail store. More specifically, they have great prices with Windows 10 OEM and retail as well. If that's not enough, you can also use my promo code RAV20 to receive 20% off the already discounted price. Just type in the product you're looking for, add it to the cart, view your cart, head to the checkout, and then type in my promo code RAV20 and see the sweet savings appear. But wait, PayPal isn't working for you? You just need to scroll down to the bottom right, click this link right here, and make sure you use that promo code they give you at checkout, and PayPal should work like a charm. Check the links in the video description to learn more.
All right, let's talk about what we'll be upgrading today. We'll be bumping up the RAM from 8GB to 16GB, like always, because it's usually the sweet spot for gaming builds these days. Then, like I said before, we'll be testing out 3 different graphics cards to see their performance in a build like this, based on their abilities and limitations. First, we'll be checking out a single slot graphics card that is very attainable for just about everyone, and it's the NVIDIA GT720. I happen to have this card on hand, so I figured out why not try it out in the X16 slot, since it's the only card I have that can actually fit in it. I actually had to end up taking off the bracket since it's a full-size card, but either way, it should work fine now that it's smaller to the half height like it should be, and this card only has 1GB of VRAM though, so I'm not really expecting it to do anything spectacular, but it only comes in at about $30 on eBay, so it's a really cheap option. Second, we're going to drop in probably the best value card to pair with this system, and that is the MSI GTX 1050 Ti 4GB low profile. This card comes with a low profile bracket, so no modification needed to fit in our small form factor case, and it has 4GB of VRAM, so it should do a lot better in newer titles that require more of that. I purchased mine for $150, and honestly, these used to go for about 80 bucks all day, so that kind of sucks, but either way, the price of performance should be great in this system for today. And third, I think you guys already knew what I was going to choose, and that is the MSI GTX 1650 4GB low profile. On the outside, this card looks a lot like the 1050 Ti and even has the same amount of VRAM, but actually should net us some more performance based on the graphs. And with our testing, I'm hoping to find out if this card is actually worth the extra $65 I paid over the 1050 Ti 4GB. So if you happen to be upgrading something like this, then maybe you can use this to your advantage.
Now, a little earlier, I mentioned some limitations. Let's talk about those limitations for a second. As you can see, the Optiplex 9020 SFF has a PCIe X4 half-length slot and a PCIe X16 slot that is full-length. Normally, you'd always want to install your GPU in the slot with the highest bandwidth, the X16 slot, but as you can see, the X16 slot is in a position here where you can only fit a single slot card. Due to this, we will have to install the GTX 1050 Ti and the 1650 in the X4 slot, and unfortunately, this will come with a small performance hit. Now, I was gonna actually mod my case here to pull out the PSU and test the performance difference myself, but it turns out someone here on YouTube already did it. A YouTuber by the name of Mr. Witsianga, I think I'm saying that right, did the modification necessary to fit a card into the X16 slot and concluded that you end up taking about a 10% performance hit in gaming due to the decreased bandwidth of the X4 slot. So thank you a ton, Mr. Witsianga. Hopefully I'm saying your name right again. I now don't have to tear apart my case to test this, and now all of you know what you can expect right out of the gate, and if you guys want to check out his full video, I'll link it down below, so definitely check that out. Anyway, with that explanation out of the way, let's start with our first set of benchmark tests. In today's video, I grabbed a few very popular games based on recommendations from you guys out there in the visuals fam and the most played games list on Steam.
So I decided on 6 different tests, starting with 3D Mark as usual, then moving on to CSGO, Valorant, GTA 5, Doom Eternal, and then finally ending with some COD Warzone. Now let's go ahead and get things started with the GT 720 graphics card, and honestly, I really don't have my hopes up. So in 3D Mark, I got things started with Night Raid, and they actually suggested this because this is for computers with integrated graphics. But even with this graphics card, yeah, it really didn't get too much of a good score here, just over 5,000. And then, no surprise to me here, I ran Firestrike and got probably my lowest score I've ever gotten with 1,145. So I think it goes without saying, I really didn't expect much as far as gaming, but I did try CSGO anyway, and like I thought, it kind of struggled to even hit 60 frames per second in this game, which is not a great play experience for this type of game at all. And yeah, usually you should be killing frame rates with this game, so this was very, very surprising. So after finding this out, I decided to just go ahead and scrap the other games and not even try them because I know they're not going to do very well. And I decided to try a little something different. So I grabbed my game controller, loaded up an emulator into this machine, and put my favorite NES and N64 games on it, booted up a couple of games, and lo and behold, this thing runs them perfectly. So you know what? If you have this type of graphics card, this is probably the only thing it's good for.
With that GT 720 out of the way, let's now slot in our 1050 Ti and see how it does. We'll be right back. right, that was a little better. Now we're getting somewhere. And finally, let's switch out the 1050 Ti for the 1650 and see if that extra $65 price tag nets us an extra $65 worth of FPS. Alright, so now that we have heavily tested this little machine out, let me tell you my real opinion on this. To be very frank with you, just don't go out and buy one of these systems. Like, the ceiling for the upgrades and the potential FPS gains is way too low for the money right now, and I just can't recommend this as a good value for you budget gamers out there. On the other hand, if you happen to be one of those lucky people that may have been given one of these systems for whatever reason, taken one home from work or something, or maybe you found one uber cheap, at that point, I say it's a great option to be a small media PC with the ability to play some new titles at respectable frame rates. Definitely pick up a 1650 low profile card, as it showed quite a bit more performance than the 1050 Ti, and it seemed much more solid in today's games. It's just really hard for me to tell people to go out and grab something like this when, right off the rip, you're going to be crippled by about 10% because of that PCIe slot problem, and you are extremely limited on the GPU upgrades you can do here. Now, if you're a gamer on a budget and you're thinking of the Optiplex systems as a possibility for a gaming PC, I'd actually point you towards the Mini Tower systems because they are much more versatile in all areas of upgradability, and there's tons of information out there to help you guys out, especially here on my channel. So that's going to be all for me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed another little PC science experiment video here on the channel. So leave a like if you did, and if you want to see more PC content like this, then get subscribed with those notifications on so you don't miss future uploads. Take care, and I'll catch you guys next time. Oh, also, if you want a cool hat like this, or if you want to get a hoodie that has the cool RA Visuals logo on it, check the merch link in the description.